Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to use performance review template created by Jira. So if you can see here, once we log in, we'll have this options available. We'll click on this and this will navigate it to the project creation. Now, let's understand what it gives us to use this template rather than using any other template. So here I've created one project by using this template, and you can see this looks very interactive. And here we have the complete status update. We are not creating any dashboards or anything while using this template, but we have everything is created by default. So if we'll navigate into the board sections, we have two options are available. Here I've created two tasks. Within that, I've created two subtasks as well. So here we have six subtasks, and here we have two subtasks. So if you can see here, I just dragged and dropped this to onboarding process to delivered. Now, when we'll return back to the summary, here we have this 10% is delivered. So this is how it is updating frequently when we are creating the Jira projects with this template. So we'll see here how to use this template for performance review, where we can utilize or view the complete team performance based on the project requirement. Now let me navigate it back to all projects. Now here we have performance review. So I'll select this performance review template and just click on create. So here I'm giving the project name as HR. Resource. Here I've selected performance review template, click on create, and that's it. Our project has been created, and you can see we have the complete blue board is available where we can create and manage complete project settings. Click on create, and here we have task options. Once we'll click on manage types, we can also add some manage types where we have the employee as well as edit flow. So everything we can manage is if we have the administrator permissions. So this is a task informations. Once we'll click on task, here we have summary descriptions. If any field is required, we can create it according to our requirement. Again, if we want to add any issue types like Epic, simply click on Epic, and we have Epic is also available. So based on the requirement, we can create any type of issue types whenever we will need it. Now I will navigate it back to the board. Here we'll click on create, and we have these options are available. So as of now, I want to create task. So let's understand the use case. Let's say HR team wants to hire few of the candidates related to the Java and some technical aspects. If they wanted to hire these type of candidates, generally they will add the requirements, and based on the requirement, manager will review it, peer will review it, and then they will take a decision, and finally this will be delivered. So let's say here I'm creating resume shortlisted. Click on create. Then we have onboarding process. Now I want to create it. Documentations. Candidate brief. So that's it. Let's continue with this one, and then probably we'll add some more items if it is required. So resume shortlistings probably have child items. So let's say they are shortlisting resume from the portal. So extracting resume from portal, one item, then filtering resume, then after that we have skill set. set match, and then let's say arranging interview. Arranging interview. Now that's the subtask. So here, let me complete this extractions of resume from the portal. Let me make it to done. Now, next one is onboarding. So onboarding process still have multiple options or multiple steps. So which we have to do it. So generally for doing this, we'll need some several steps. So onboarding process will have the form filling, document verifications, then briefing. Let's say form filling is done. I'm making few of the steps done so that we can have the complete status report available into our board. Now in documentation portal here, we'll add child items. So in child item, let's cancel this. Child items, we have education document, now we have personal like PAN card and Aadhaar card, PAN, Aadhaar, now we have experience certificate, etc. Again, this one is educational documents is already submitted. Let me make it done. And then candidate briefing. So in candidate briefing, HR is generally arranging the sessions with the different team members. Total depending on the organization size or the team size. So here, let's say adding IT, InfoSec, then after InfoSec, let's say we have HRMS, then finance, etc. So let's say HRMS is done, or maybe we can mark it to in progress. Now these steps are done. Let me make it to resume shortlisting into manager review. When we'll return back to the summary page, here we have all the details are available. You can see for review 3, to do isn't 10, decision not made anything, in progress 1, manager review 1, and total items we have 18. And you can see priority breakdown is everything is medium, because whenever we are creating tasks, subtasks, is by default it's taking medium. If we want to increase it, we can do it. Here we can see types of work, how many are subtasks, how many are from the task, totally depending on the counts. Related projects, if you want, we can also add it. Nothing is assigned, otherwise we can see the complete team board here. So if it is assigned to any particular person, we can see the detail here. How many are created? Total 18 items are created. 18 are updated. As of now, in next 7 days, nothing is due because we have not defined anything. 3 items are in done state. So this is a complete stat about the project. Here we can see the board details. So in board details, if you want, we can edit it exactly same like Jira list. So in list, we have everything, the major items which is available, we can see the leads. And even if it is assigned, we can see the assigned due date. If we have any due dates available, we can have this due dates. And once we'll update this due dates and return back to the summary, we have one item is available in next 7 days. It's not showing. So let me go back and just make it to within 7 days. So here, we have one item in next 7 days, which is showing the priority items for any teams. In calendar sections here, this item is marked. So generally, this will highlight the complete stats inside the calendar so that team will be on track. By using this site, they will be able to understand, yes, this items, we have to finish it as soon as possible. Inside the timelines, you can see these are the timelines. Generally, based on the due dates, it will allocate automatically. If we have any forms created, we can see all these details. Then issues, which all issues we have inside this, we can see with the complete stats. Even if you want, we can export issues in different formats like XML, RSS, export RSS, then Word, HTML, XML, and XLS. If we want to do the search in advanced parameter, we can also apply the filter. In report sections, we can generate the reports within the templates as well. So totally useful when we want to generate any graph. Even we can customize this product according to our requirement. So this is very useful when we are working with the tight deadlines and when we want to generate the graph with proper calculations. So generally here we can see the complete stats. If you want to share with any of the team members, we can use it. So this is how it will help our team to understand project criticality as well as the deadlines about the projects. So that's all about the Jira template performance review. Hope you enjoyed this. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.